Hi, Anthony here. This is one in a series of videos on how to build your website in WordPress. In this video, I'm going to walk you through the WordPress user interface as well as the settings. In the previous video, I showed you how to use the WordPress setup wizard. And in this video, you will learn how to make manual changes to your website settings. So I'm logged into my WordPress dashboard. What you see here may be a bit different because you can customize this dashboard. If you click this screen options button, you can decide what sections display on your main dashboard. If you click on your profile in the top right corner, you can edit your profile, as well as change the look and feel of the dashboard. One of the first things you may want to do is change your password, and make sure to save your changes. Under Posts, initially you will only see this default post, which you will have to delete and create your own post if you're going to have a blog section. In the Media section is where all your media will be saved, like images, videos, and audio. Under Pages is where you can create all the pages of your website. This is where you'll probably spend most of your time, especially if you're building a static website. Under Appearance is where you can customize the look and feel of your website. You will notice several subsections here, like Themes, where you can customize your theme, add and manage widgets, menus, and many other customization options. I will be creating separate tutorials on how to install themes as well as how to customize themes. Under Plugins is where you can install WordPress plugins. And again, I will be creating a separate tutorial on how to manage plugins. Under Users, you can set up other users to manage your website. Under Settings, you can manage global settings like your website title, URL, etc. Under Writing Settings, you can set up your email. Under Reading Settings, you can set up your home page as a blog or a static page. Under Discussion Settings, you can manage settings for comments. Under Media Settings, you can set the default image sizes. Under Permalink Settings, you can set up how your post URLs display. This is especially useful for SEO purposes. Under Privacy Settings, you can set up your privacy policy. Some of these options in the sidebar will depend on the plugins that you install, but this is pretty much an overview of the WordPress back office. In the next video, I'll show you how to install a WordPress theme. I hope you found this video helpful. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section. And thanks for watching!